Today we hear from a modern master of the tenor saxophone, a soulful stylist with a strong feeling for the blues, known to the world as Mr. T, jazz legend Stanley Turrentine.
Thank you.
You said it. Stanley Turrentine in 62 with his brother and composer of that tune, Tommy, on trumpet. Kenny Burrell played guitar, Sonny Clark piano, Butch Warren bass, and Al Harewood drums. Stanley Turrentine's melodic and bluesy sound is an important link in the jazz tenor tradition. A prolific recording artist during the 60s, he was as much a part of the fabric at Blue Note as trumpeter Lee Morgan or pianist Horace Silver. But because of his commercial success in the more popular idioms of the day, he's sometimes overlooked as a jazz player. And there's a lot to appreciate, as we'll hear over the next hour. Shortly before his death in 2000, Turrentine talked to Alan Shipton about his upbringing in Pittsburgh and his father, Thomas Turrentine, who also played tenor in a group called the Savoy Sultans.
He put the horn in my hand when I was about 9.5 years old. And he was very instrumental in my distinctive sound, so they say I have. And he used to stand me in the corner. I used to be, my lesson would be one note at a time. And he would say, "Stanley, did you hear that note?" I said, "Well, Dad, I can't help but hear it. I'm standing in the corner, and it's all coming right back at me." But, you know, when he was, later I found out what he meant by that. He was teaching me, you know, how to hear the note, how to play the note in tune. What vibrato I used would change the sound, the kind of air flow that I would put through the horn. It would all be the same note, but you could change and play it so many different ways, just that one note. And I think I'm still trying to get to that, you know.
Did he do the same thing with your brother? I mean,
no, Tommy was, he was a very talented guy. He went out on the road when he was about with George Hudson, a band out of St. Louis. And I used to remember him, you know, writing, like he used to write songs out for me, melodies on paper bags. Or he would write on just any kind of paper that he could find. And Tommy was just more or less just went out of it and just did it. And he was very instrumental in me getting started, in a way, to play jazz. The first jazz band I ever played in was Tommy's band. We played at a club in Pittsburgh called the Perry Bar. And I paid, he was supposed to pay me $5, but he never paid me.
Your brothers can get away with that. Well, yeah, Pittsburgh must have been an exciting place to grow up, because,
oh,
I mean, the people like Art Blakey and Ray Brown.
Yeah.
A whole generation.
Well, you know, Earl Garner, Linton Garner, who Billy Eckstein, Lena Horne, Mary Lou Williams. There's a lot of people. You know, during the time when I was growing up, man, there was music all around. You know, when I walk out the door in a radius of 5 blocks, I've heard 5 combinations of bands, like trio or quartet or a solos piano player, just within the 4 blocks. It was always some music around. Somebody was playing something somewhere any time of the day. They used to have jam sessions at the Musicians Club in Pittsburgh that lasted for 24 hours. One guy takes another guy's place and would go on and on and on.
Did you graduate to playing in those yourself at one stage?
I sure did. Went down in the, oh yeah, yeah, the Musician Club was, that was part of my schooling. I didn't go to a music school or anything, and that was really, I'd go down to the Musicians Club, and you see people at like Illinois Jacket, Charlie Parker would come up there. I remember distinctly that Art Tatum, they had a upright piano, and I saw Art Tatum playing. He was playing so much stuff, and I saw him reach with his left hand and to grab a beer off the top. And I was looking for another hand. I said, I thought this guy was, he was just phenomenal. And, you know, Nat King Cole used to come up and play. You know, I used to go and sit in the corner and watch these guys when I was about, you know, 11, 12 years old. You know, I knew the Secretary of the Union by the name of James, Earl Brown, I'm talking. Yeah. And he used to let me sit in the corner. I used to see all these great musicians come up and play. And they jam, you know, till the wee hours in the morning. And I get balled out when I get home.
It's great education. What was the first band you went on the road with?
I went with Lowell Fulson's band.
Guitar player.
Blues band. With Ray Charles. He was a featured pianist and vocalist. And we traveled all the way, you know, all over the South.